need somebody who can love me and my words. Oh, I'm not perfect, but I hope you see my worth. Cause it's only you, nobody knew I put you first. And for you, girl, I swear I'd do my worst.
I want everyone to picture the thing they fear the very most and turn it into something funny. Next! Ron!
Oh, my great Aunt Tessie! Smell like my great Aunt Tessie.
Hey, she's only interested in you because she thinks you're the chosen one.
I am the chosen one. Okay, sorry.
Ridiculous!
Ridiculous!
This class is ridiculous.
Very good.
Quiet, please.
Shut it!
Thanks.
I can see them too. You're just as sane as I am.
Warden, the house now.
Trevor! Sorry.
You know, George, I've always felt our futures lay outside the world of academic achievement. Fred, I've been thinking exactly the same thing.
No. Ooh. Yeah, that's...
I feel like people have a very specific image in mind when I think of writers.
Oh my god, you can create stories from scratch and then craft them into words and make books. That's so rewarding.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It totally is.
Homie, half the time, I don't know what words are.
This is probably more accurate.
All right, let's get started. I forgot my tea. All right, we're set. Let's get started. What's the main character's name? This one sentence in paragraph 3 is bothering me. I'll keep it. All right, now I've really got to buckle down and focus and... Oh, tea's cold. Okay, I'm feeling this. This is good. Or is it?
Oh my, oh my, oh my god. This girl straight and this girl nah. And this girl nah. And this girl nah. And this girl nah. And this girl nah.
I've never felt like this before. Honey, honey, how he thrills me.
There are four species of writers.
The one-liner
brainstorms all day, has a minor breakdown, goes for a jog, writes one line, and calls it a day. The procrastinator writer will do anything to not write. They compulsively snack. They stretch before a jog, but never get around to jogging. The non-writer writer stares at the cursor and thinks, an idea will come someday, somehow, any minute now. The writer wakes up at 6 a.m., sits his butt down, churns out 12 pages without bathroom breaks, goes for a brisk run, and does it all over again the next day. There are many of these writers, some of these writers, and absolutely effing none of these writers.
Okay, so you're this? Yeah. But you want this? Yeah. Okay, so in order to get that, you'd have to do this.
Are you in the right headspace to receive information that could possibly hurt you?
If you're a writer or storyteller, stick around. I have some websites I want to show you.
Tabletop Audio is really great if you're like me and you really like having background noise when you write. They have so many different songs and ambiances, as well as an option to customize all of the background noises, where you can pick all of these individual noises and put them together to create an ambiance that's the perfect setting for your writing. Canva is great for creating book covers. They have a bunch of templates to choose from, as well as all sorts of different graphics and photos that you can use to customize it however you want. If you write fantasy and you do world building, World Anvil is a really great way to organize your world. Art Breeder is a really good place to design your characters, as well as Picrew, Doll Divine, and Metahuman Creator, which has become one of my favorites. If you want to make a map but you don't want to draw it from scratch, try Incarnate, Asgard's Fantasy Map Generator, or Roll for Fantasy's Map Creator. This website also has a bunch of other useful resources.
I don't want you.
Can we skip to the good part?
It doesn't really work that way.
What do you mean? I did the thing with the hand.
Yeah, no, that's not actually real.
It's not?
You have to actually finish it.
I do?
Yeah.
Ah, fuck.
This is gonna be so epic. When I publish this, there will be a whole fandom. A kingdom fandom. People are gonna write fanfics. I'm gonna get a Netflix deal. There's going to be fan art. Everyone in the whole entire world is gonna know about this book series and I-
Hey, hon. What you working on?
Oh, nothing. It's nothing. Nothing. It's nothing.
It's like a reward.
In case you guys are wondering where I'm at in editing Blade Breaker, this is where I'm at. This is my last Google search. Ways to say said. If you're a writer, you understand.
Part 2 of website resources for writers. Writing with color is a really great way to make sure that you're providing proper representation in your work. They have a whole staff of people from all sorts of different backgrounds and answer all sorts of questions. If you need help visualizing a very specific sort of landscape, you can use this program called Gauguin. There are lots of different brushes and tools that you can use to just basically draw some blobs and it'll turn it into this landscape. While NaNoWriMo is mostly focused on their yearly challenge in November, there are still lots of resources on this website that are useful. You can create projects and then set goals of word counts and start and end dates, and it'll give you different graphs and statistics and numbers to help you make sure that you're reaching your goals on time. If you write fantasy and you want to come up with some original creatures and need some inspiration, try this random animal generator by Generator Mix. It will give you a certain number of completely random animals that you can then mix and match to create something entirely new. And a lot of people in my last video recommended Campfire Blaze for writing and organizing. I personally haven't used it, but I've heard a lot of good things.
If the Earth Kingdom discovers us, they'll have us killed.
But if the Fire Nation discovers us, we'll be turned over to Azula.
Earth Kingdom it is.